So whether you're analyzing an ectotherm or an endotherm, you're going to end up with a heat of storage after you sum up all the sources of heat inputs and outputs. But the question is, does delta HS raise body temperature? And if so, how fast? Okay, so from our sample calculations handout, we had a problem where the delta HS is 437 kilojoules per hour. Okay, for a human being who has a mass of 70 kilograms. Okay, so we're going to use the specific heat equation. So Q, so the heat Q, so we put in our delta HS here. Okay, and Q equals CM delta T. Okay, so now we're going to make this assumption that a body is about the same as water, the specific heat of water. We are 70% or more water, so that's a pretty good approximation. And the specific heat of water is 4 joules per degree Celsius per gram, or 1 calorie per degree Celsius per gram. 1 calorie is about 4 joules. 4 joules and change, but we can just call it 4. Okay, so that's what C is, and then the mass is 70, and then the delta T is what we're solving for here. Okay, so putting those values in, HS equals 4 joules per degree Celsius per gram times mass times delta T. So putting in our known values, we can now solve for, of our known values of the heat of storage and the mass. Now we're going to solve for delta T. Okay, so so 437 kilojoules per hour. We can convert that into joules because there's 1,000 joules per kilojoule. Okay, so that'll cancel. And then what we have is 437,000 joules per hour equals, multiplying this out, 280,000 joules grams per degree Celsius times delta T. So dividing both sides by 280,000 joules grams degrees Celsius, okay, what we get is delta T turns out to be, and of course the units cancel, turns out to be 1.56 degrees Celsius per hour. Okay, this is how much the difference in temperature is. The next question is, how long until he reaches 44 degrees Celsius? This is like upper critical temperature, or, you know, basically brain death, or at least the start of it. Okay, so now take a look at this. And what we want to know is the time here, right? So how do we figure this out? Okay, so this is the temperature that the upper end that it will reach. Yeah, so instead of writing delta T equals 1.56 degrees Celsius per hour, we can call this T2 minus T1. Okay, and then if we bring it down here, so if we notice delta T is in units of degrees Celsius per hour, and these guys are in units of degrees Celsius. So if we just solve this, So this is our upper critical temperature here. We assume that he started at 37, and then we're trying to figure out how long it takes to span this 1.56 degrees Celsius per hour. Okay, so this is 7 degrees Celsius. So the body temperature has to change by 7 degrees Celsius, and it's doing so at a rate of about 1.5 per hour. Okay, so if we divide 7 by 1.56, the degrees Celsius will cancel and the hours will go upstairs, and we'll be left with 4.5 hours, 4.48 hours. Okay, so it will take about 4.5 hours. This guy has about 4.5 hours until he reaches upper critical temperature and brain death or brain damage. Okay, so it's just like practicing with algebra. It's not that bad, and you can remember it and do it. So just practice, okay? Great. See you in class.